Good morning. It's day 7 from my little nook in the forest. And today, for the first day in this whole trip, I slept really badly. Now, it might have been because of the black flies. And there's what they do to you. And and I got that at the Riviera de Hoyoub, which makes sense because that's where black flies grow. It might also have been because my Seroquels, my evening pills, don't always mix with the food that I eat, and I had the curry last night, and that might have been a factor. I don't know. Anyhow, I'm just brewing stuff up here, getting ready for the morning. But it all made me think of a guy called Johan Gurenev, or something like that, who cycled from Alaska to the tip of Argentina. I followed every bit of his adventures. I even funded him. He had the same problem as I. Can't sleep at night. And I'll tell you, without something to help you sleep at night, that's the most miserable thing. Now, he ended up in an untimely end. I don't intend to meet the same fate. These are my pills. The half yellow ones there, those are the Seroquels. They stop my mind from spinning and spinning and spinning and repeating the same thing over and over and over again and preventing me from sleeping. The blue ones are low dose aspirin because I'm large. Over here, we have three. We have the yellow ones, which are Crestor. We have the little ones, which are Reactine. That just helps me breathe a little bit more easily. And the big ones, I think they're called Wellbutrin. They might be slightly differently named. And those are the workhorses for me. They prevent me from from making everything seem worse than it is, being afraid of everything, panicking about everything. And you can imagine, if I'm panicking about everything and going over everything over and over and over in my mind, I don't sleep well. I don't live well. And every few years, I have a full-blown meltdown. This prevents that. And this combination, it took a while to get to this. This works pretty well for me. This is what I wish Johan Gurenev had had. I really do. Because he'd still be with us.
The big challenge with these pills is weight control, which is why I like to get as much exercise as I can and why I do the biking, although I've always been interested in biking, but really seriously only for about the last 15 years or so. In the mornings, I live on 2 packets of Quaker's oats and then a handful of granola all mixed into this. And that's what one of these, I'm sorry about the fork, that's one of what one of these trips does for me too. It really enforces my diet and keeps me trim and in better shape. You know, it's all a package, right? And right now, I may be 320 pounds and 63 years old, but it's working. I mean, look at me.
This is the Castor River, right around kilometer 82. And it's where I'm going to stop up with some fresh water. Quick road report. We're around 90, 92 kilometers. As you can see, the main road still looks pretty good. It's a little gravel here and there, but nothing serious. This is a side road going off to Tête à Jupiter. In other words, the head of the Jupiter River. As you can see, it's a bit rougher, but it still is bikeable. I'm not sure how long it's bikeable, but certainly at the start it is. I'm not going down there though. I wish I could, but not this time. Well, there's There's what you like to see, eh? Bike on its back. So I've had a few issues with the bike. The back wheel now has been bending, and I've had to straighten it out a couple of times with this. And the front wheel, the fork is loose, which gives you a wobble as you ride, and I don't know how to fix that. So I've been wobbling for several hundred, 150 kilometers now. Yeah, it's a ramshackle life.
The 106 kilometer mark, I reached Auberge Macdonald, where I stopped for a couple hours to have some snacks and recharge my batteries.
This is the Point Carlton Lighthouse, and it's just about a kilometer north of where I'll be staying tonight. I don't think it gets much use anymore, judging by the way it's all boarded up, but it's still pretty cool to look at. And of course, every time I take a video, there's a car in the background. Nobody here. Yeah. So that truck that came by and then stopped was asking me where I'm going next, and I guess he was worried that I would be camping here at the lighthouse, which I'm sure is a no-no, especially considering there's so many other places you could camp. And you know, I want to say I don't really mind that. The people at CPAC, which is the Quebec Parks Agency, have been nothing but helpful throughout my entire trip. I have nothing but good things to say about them. So yeah, a little check, don't mind that at all. My stealth camp was around the 75 kilometer mark of the Trans-Anticostian, right around here somewhere. Followed the highway into the coast, nice downhill there, and then along the coast to the Shadow Macdonald, which is here. Continued following the coast until I reached the lighthouse here on this point, and then only a kilometer or so down from the lighthouse, here we have Camping Wilcox in this really nice bay. This is Camping Wilcox. I thought it would be right on the shore, since the shore is like a couple hundred meters that way, but it isn't. I was wrong. And I guess I should have learned by now not to be making assumptions about this place. Also, against all odds, there are two other groups of campers here. So, no loud rave parties, I guess. Anyhow, tomorrow I'm taking a zero. I deserve it. Today's meal is spicy sausage pasta. Looking forward to that. And also a little bit of applesauce that I liberated from the chalet that I was just at. And let me see, here's my cooker cooking. And I've also just had a shower and I feel great. Just great. Just for the record, I also liberated 3 cans of Pepsi, 2 cans of Perrier water, 1 water, a ham and cheese bun, and a macaroni salad. And they knew all about it, and they were great.